So good afternoon, everyone. CSIR is organizing a 1 week, one lab program to disseminate its achievements and accomplishment to the society. In this connection, CDRI is organizing this event from 13th February to 18th February. And in this connection, we are organizing webinars on our popular products which are in market people are using them and getting benefit from them. And it's our pleasure to have the inventor, or we can say the developer of that product, Dr. Rakesh Maurya and Dr. Ritu Trivedi and Dr. Lal Hingorani, who brought this product to the market. So now we listen from them. So first of all, I want Dr. Ritu Trivedi talk about this achievement. Please, Dr. Ritu Trivedi.
Thank you, Sanjeev. I think it is always a pleasure, and especially when you have something gone into the market. And as you just said, I'm joined by Dr. Rakesh Maurya. He's a medicinal chemist, and with his collaboration and with him, we have been able to develop a product. And I also have Dr. Lal Hingorani, who is the CEO of Farmenza Herbals Private Limited, who helped us take this technology and take it into the market. So I'll tell you this short story of discovery of reunion from Delbergia Sisu, and then we'll also listen from Dr. Rakesh Maurya and Dr. Hingorani about these comments. Can we begin, Dr. Hingorani and Dr. Maurya?
Yes.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. Okay, so this story is about reunion, and reunion is a product that is there in the market that stimulates new bone formation and reduces the bone turnover markers. And it is there for fracture healing and osteoporosis management. And I'll take you through the development of reunion and how it has finally been commercialized and is in the market. I'm speaking on behalf of many, many people whom you can see on this slide. And you can see that there are chemists, there are biologists, there are people from pharmaceutics and kinetics division. You can see Dr. Rakesh Maurya over here, Dr. Lal Hingorani, Prabhat is here from pharmaceutics and kinetics division, and all so many students who have participated and helped us bring this product into the market. In fact, we have people from business development, Naseem and Shripati from patent. We've all got together to bring this product into the market. Now, why did we at all choose this disease called osteoporosis? Is basically because if you see around the world, there is 1 in 3 women and 1 in 5 men who suffer above the age of 50 years from osteoporosis. So it's a pressing disease, and it comes into the area of unmet medical need. And for all those people, osteoporosis is a disease that is characterized by low bone mass and followed by microarchitectural deterioration of the bone tissue. And because of this, it leads to enhanced bone fragility and increased fracture risk. And you can see on the slide on my left is the normal bone, and in the right where osteoporotic bone, in which you can see the trabecula are so far apart, because of which it leads to bone fragility and finally bone fractures. And if you go to a clinician, he'll tell you if the spinal bone BMD is below minus 2.5 standard deviations, that means you come into the category of osteoporosis, or you're osteoporotic. There are many, many treatments available, beginning from bisphosphonates to bone forming drugs to drugs with different mechanism. But amongst all of these, bone formation is a therapy is the most desirable one, because it helps bone tissue to be formed more, as opposed to the cells that are resorbing bone. And bisphosphonates are fraught with many side effects. We have PTH in the category of bone forming agent, that is teriparatide, that is in the market, but it is the last line of therapy. It is injectable, it is costly, because of which we as scientists are looking for new bone forming agents. So together with Dr. Maurya, we looked at many, many plants, and he'll show you that so many plants we screened. Out of this chemical diversity that is present in the plants, we found Dilbergia sisu, and you can see so many compounds being isolated from here to here. And we were lucky to have this molecule in the center that you see, which is known as cavionin glucopyroside. And in my coming up discussion, I have abbreviated as CAFG from each of these, and I'll speak about it. Because we identified this, we were able to file a patent for application for fracture healing and postmenopausal osteoporosis, and the patent has also been granted. And this is the novel molecule that helped us go forward in these studies. And the chemistry let us compounds isolated based on the polarity as it is. We isolated 16 compounds, out of which we had 4 of them which are osteogenic in nature. And the fourth one that you see, the cavionin glycopyroside, is the novel one that I was talking about. And if you see amongst them, if you see over here, the K024 or the cavionin CAFG, as I have abbreviated, is present in the highest amount, in the most abundance, in 5% of the total extract. And this was really, really exciting for us. And then we went ahead to check its efficacy in the postmenopausal osteoporosis and fracture healing experiments. These are the highlights of the experiments that I'm showing you. And if you see at 250 to 500 milligram per kg body weight, it was effective. In the postmenopausal condition also, it showed its efficacy, and these were kind of exciting data for us. Not only was it able to form bone, we also wanted to see its femoral bone strength and the vertebral compressive strength, which are important parameters when new bone is getting formed. And we found that Dilbergia was able to not only form bone, but it was able to form bone of great strength also. Then these are some of the experiments with the help of which we see that what is happening inside the bone and how much bone is getting formed per day. I mean, these are histomorphometric data, which is dynamic in nature. And we could see that if you see the bone formation rate and mineral apposition rate, both of them gave us information that the new bone was getting formed in micrometers per day is the rate at which the new bone was getting formed. So from all these inferences, not only did we publish them, but we could inference from this data that Dilbergia improves bone parameters, but it has dual mode of action. That means it involves prevention of bone loss and formation of new bone. But we were really excited to see what is the magic with the novel molecule that we had identified, which as I said, that I have abbreviated as CAFG. We found some exciting data that now we made comparisons with parathyroid hormone, alendronate, and since its molecular similarity was also with genistein, and we were able to show that as low as 1 milligram per kg body weight, you see over here, it is able to form bone, not only in vitro conditions, but also in the estrogen withdrawal or estrogen deficient animals, it could form bone. This is again the dynamic histomorphometry, and the width of this arrow will tell you that as opposed to over-ectomized condition, you can see that the effective amount of bone is getting formed when CAFG is administered. It was not estrogenic, and for osteoporosis therapy, it is very, very important that the drugs, the molecules should not be estrogenic, because estrogen has its deleterious effects. It causes breast and uterine cancers. In fact, hormone replacement therapy was withdrawn because of these concerns. And because of this, any kind of therapeutics for osteoporosis is first checked if it is estrogenic or not estrogenic. And we were able to see that CAFG was not estrogenic in nature. It showed its positive effects on the chondrocytes. That means the bone, when it starts getting formed, it's not ossified or it is not mineralized. And the effect on the chondrocytes so shows that it stimulated the chondrocyte cells to form more bone. In fact, our experiments on bone regeneration in fractures showed that it was able to form bone as early as 11 days, as opposed to 21 days, which is the normal process of bone being formed. So you see bone over here, a drill hole is made, and then we check that how much bone is getting formed and in how much time, and it could form bone as early as 11 days. Then we wanted to see the mechanism of how it is formed, and it was exciting to see that CAFG, this molecule, stimulated the Wnt signaling pathway, and phosphorylation of GSK3-beta allowed beta-catenin to go inside the cells, and it stimulated this RUNX2 factor and transcription factor, and with the help of which the bone is getting formed. On right-hand side panel, you will see all the experiments that were performed to show that how it is done. Not only did it stimulate the Wnt signaling pathway, it also stimulated the BMP2 pathway by stimulating the SMADS and P38 pathway, and thus the osteogenic response. Our next experiment was to see what happens to the cell which is in its close proximity and which resorbs bone, the osteoclast cells. And you will see that while CAFG helped form more bone, it could suppress the levels of osteoclast and trap tartrate resistant acid phosphatase as its marker. It arrested its the trap enzyme to be formed less in amount, because of which osteoclastogenesis was arrested, and we could see increased bone formation happening. So the earlier, I was telling you that it has dual mode of action, and it was verified or corroborated by our experiments done in terms of its mechanism of action, that it does have dual mode of action. In osteoblast cells, it will help you form more bone. It will keep the osteoclast suppressed or arrested, because of which it helps bone formation happening as early as 11 days, as we saw. So in terms of mechanism of action, we have been able to prove that it promotes osteoblast differentiation by the Wnt beta BMP2 catenin mechanism. Detailed toxicity studies were done, and these were done with the help of Dr. Hingorani. These studies shows that 90-day oral toxicity and 28-day toxicity presented no signs of toxicity. In fact, it did not pose toxicity up to a level of 1,240 milligrams per kg body weight. It was non-cytogenetic. It did not induce gene mutations by base pair changes of frame shifts in the genomes of the strains used. And in terms of milestones, all this study, all these experiments were licensed. The name was given Reunion, and Dr. Hingorani, you can see on the right, who took this technology, and the first clinical trial were registered for fracture healing. And the data from this clinical trial shows that yes, Delbergia sisu forms callus, reduces pain and edema with no adverse side effects whatsoever in humans also. This is how the product looks like. And you see Farmenza over here, and it is being marketed by Iris Life Sciences. In fact, the process of how the whole journey of Reunion, a documentary has been made, and it's on YouTube. You can see it on YouTube, that how it is being formed. These are some of the awards and recognitions that for Reunion that give us confidence that it moved in the right direction. Not only the other awards, but also you see the impact award, the STEM impact award. I mean, what the kind of impact it is creating in the society is something that gives to us researchers a lot of confidence that yes, the product is doing well. It's also a moment of pride when it is covered in the lay press and people come to know, people are able to use it as a therapy for fracture healing and osteoporosis. And if you look at the worth of Delbergia, you'll see we've published profusely, and all this is in the public domains with 10 PhD students who've completed their PhD here. And in terms of social statistics, the captive collection that is happening in Madhya Pradesh allows this tribal population to not only have revenue for themselves, but it also helps protecting trees. And this is the number, like this has benefited so many patients. And till date, we have not heard of any adverse effects whatsoever. We continue to do estimation of the novel marker in Union, and this is with the help of Prabhat Mishra, who's in the Pharmaceutics and Kinetics Division, who helps us get the uniformity of the novel marker in these Union tablets. And we haven't stopped here. The clinical trial one, which was in fracture healing, and the second trial in the osteoporotic women, which shows that it demonstrated anti-osteoporotic activity. And in fact, it did not allow the women whose bone mineral density had fallen down to decline further, and it helped them in their musculoskeletal symptoms. Now we've licensed it with Avita Biomix, and we want to take it as a pharmaceutical drugs as per USDA US FDA guidelines. And so we see its future, that it will be available for poor, for bone health in general, and osteoporosis in particular with severe morbidity, and it should be available worldwide in coming time. With this, I think I stop with the message that I think it's important that we love our bones and we break barriers and not our bones. And we'll have a few words with Dr. Maurya and also Dr. Hingorani. Dr. Maurya, would you like to say something?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, Dr. Ritu. In this program, we have investigated about 53 Indian medicinal plants, and we were interested to in the plants where we can have renewable source, and the Dalbergia sisu was one of the plants where we have used its leaves. And I'm very much proud that after a lot of research, and we have brought this product in the market with the help of Dr. Lal.
Yeah. Yes, Dr. Maurya. I think we should also hear from Dr. Hingorani what he wants to say.
Yeah. Thank you very much. It was my pleasure working with CDRI team and the product that we had selected. Especially for the bone health, and which is a big problem for the senior citizens. And we worked because if they are osteoporotic or they have osteopenia, if they fall down, there are more chances of having fractures. And at that age, if you get a fracture, it's very difficult to take care of the same. So this can be both prophylactic as well as curative product. We initially launched it for the fracture healing. That time we did a clinical trial on fracture healing, and it gave a very good results in that. And then we went for a 1-year study in the postmenopausal women, which is also a very big group who get to osteoporotic because of the changes in their system. So that time they lose a lot of bone density, and it gave in that 1 year, it gave very good results, which was done with Dr. Rama Vaidya, Dr. Ashok Vaidya, and Dr. Meeta at Hyderabad. So they did that study. Results were very good. And on that basis, we published it and launched it in osteoporosis also. Results are coming very well. There are two things in that. One is we are taking care of our senior citizens very well. And second is the sustainability. In Madhya Pradesh, they have banned the cutting of these trees. So those people like tribal population who are depending upon these products from the forest, they are not able to get anything from the timber. But this will give them a sustainable supply of the leaves, which we buy from them, so they get their living out of this. And our forests are protected also, because they will try to pressure those trees, and they will see that those trees are not cut for the timber. So both the benefits for the tribal population, for our forest, as well as end use, that is the product is green. We have stabilized the product, and after taking it from CDRI, we scaled it up to the commercial scale. The problems which we came in the first year, we sorted that out. Formulations were developed again. And today the product is very stable and all these things. And I'm happy that somebody is taking up for the IND filing in the USA. And at least, if not as a drug, at least as a nutraceutical, it'll be very much useful in that market, because there also the lot of old population exists, and a lot of people do not like those injectables which are available, because there are a lot of ADRs in that, and you can take it, some of the products which are there, that you can take it only once in your lifetime. So if you again get it, like, you have a problem, what to do with that. So this is a very safe product, and very happy to have this product in our this thing portfolio. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Hingorani. I think
thank you, Dr. Hingorani, as well as thank you, Dr. Maurya and Dr. Ritu Trivedi, for enlightening the other people also about this valuable product of CDRI. Thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
Ooh.